Send help to the poor today. This is our topic. Our Bible reading is from the book of Proverbs, chapter 11, verse 25. I read, "The liberal soul shall be made fat, and he that watereth shall be watered also himself." Proverbs 11:25. The poor has always had a special place in God's heart, and for this reason, you will observe that caring for them is a high priority obligation for those who work with him. Abraham was so addicted to caring for the poor that he organized a feast for total strangers who were just passing by. Genesis 18:25. When God was giving the Mosaic law, he ensured that his people recognize the poor in their society, and he required them to make special provisions for them. Leviticus 19:9-10. When the Lord Jesus Christ came to demonstrate the nature and character of God to us, he showed compassion to the poor and preached the gospel to them. You get that in the book of Mark, chapter 8, verse 2, and Luke 7:22. Having learned from him, the early disciples also made provisions for the poor. Romans 15:26. Caring for the poor is therefore a cardinal aspect of our faith as Christians. Galatians 2:20. Please, my viewers, try to go through these scriptures and read it yourself. In our today's Bible reading, the blessedness of giving to the poor is revealed to us. One of the blessings associated with this good deed is that as you remember to cater for the poor, you are unknowingly ministering deliverance to yourself. Psalm 41 verse 1 says that the Lord will deliver those who consider the poor in the time of trouble. When the Almighty God says he will deliver from trouble, he means all kinds of trouble, be it financial, physical, spiritual, material, or career-wise. When the widow of Zarephath considered giving her last meal to the hungry prophet, little did she know that she was ministering deliverance from starvation to herself and her household. 1 Kings 17:9-14. The Lord will also preserve and keep alive those who remember the poor. In other words, if you are praying for long life, a sure path to receiving this is by giving to the poor. God will grant you long life so that the poor who depend on you will have something to live on through you. Additionally, those who remember the poor will be blessed upon the earth. In other words, the Lord will make material provisions available for them to the point of overflow. As a matter of fact, if you are a farmer, you will reap a bumper harvest, which you can carry out the divine assignment of feeding the poor, because you cannot give what you do not have. As a business person or contractor, you will not lack contracts, and your turnover shall be divinely influenced. It is one thing to make money, and it is another thing to spend the money on good things. Many people spend a large proportion of their income on sickness, so much as that those with less income are far better off. Think about it. To those who remember the poor, the Lord has given a great promise to visit and strengthen them whenever they are sick. Psalm 41 verse 3. Imagine what will happen when the great healer comes visiting you when you are sick and he makes your bed for you. This is nothing but free healing on a platter of gold. What a heartwarming promise of God this is. Therefore, encourage you to remember the poor around you today and consistently put a smile on the face of the destitute. Do it today. It has helped me. Giving to the poor has helped me a lot. In my ministry, in my office, in my house, in my family, I always give to the poor. Try this today, and may the Lord bless you. In Jesus' mighty name, amen.